I'll tell you a story, I swear that it's true. Some of the details I can't relate to you. You see, I was quite young then, but now I'm growing old. So gather round and listen to this tale as it unfolds. I was the youngest of eight, with our land in civil war, and I had to remain to help my father tend the store. The work, it was hard, and the dollars, they were few. Only that I wished that I could be a soldier in blue. My brother, James Alfred, is only 18 years. Enlisting help, old Uncle Sam was hurt both far and near. So he went off to war in the 19th Infantry, a young boy southward bound on a train for Tennessee. While I was here at home up in northern Illinois, well, little did I learn of death and pain, of love and joy. But James' point of view is changing in the fields of war and strife, when your gun and friends are all that count as you hold on to your life. Standing guard at dusk, he was joking with his pal. You see, a year of confrontation, well, it tempered their morale. But a shot barked out through the night. James looked into the sky. At that moment on our porch, he gave his last goodbye. On April 17th, 1862, in the evening when we heard the pounding sound of heavy shoes, well, I looked out the window, saw James Alfred there on the porch with his rifle and his eyes up in the air. Well, Ma cried, "James Alfred, you've come home from the war." And with me behind Dad and Ma, we bolted for the door. But when the door was opened, no one was standing there, just the dust on the porch and the cool, clear night air. Now that war has been over for many, many years. Between that dreadful time and now, this tale's been told both far and near. So the memory of James Alfred I now pass on to you. He left to be a soldier, but came back a ghost in blue.